There's evidence of another mass fish kill event in far western New South Wales, 9 months after millions of fish were found dead on the nearby banks of the Darling River. The video, which was released to SBS World News, shows the dried and decaying bodies of fish on the banks of Lake Pamamaroo near the town of Menindee. It was filmed today as part of the documentary When the River Runs Dry by filmmakers Rory McLeod and Peter Yates. They say they believe the fish died because the lake is drying up rather than algal blooms and lack of fresh flows, which led to the last fish kills.
Not the best day out, but very, yeah, very confronting sight. Just so many big fish. I've never seen so many big fish in my life. And all dead.
The New South Wales Department of Fisheries has been contacted for comment. Parts of regional New South Wales are counting down the days before water supplies are set to run out. It's been predicted towns in the central west could run out of water as early as November, as the state faces a drought of unprecedented proportions. But for many further west, sourcing reliable water has never been an easy task.
Daryl Cowie is the owner of the Burke and Wills Motel in Menindee. He says there's never a day that goes by the town isn't thinking about where their water is coming from.
We just got to rely on what comes down the river. And because it's so, we're so dependent on that, what happens upstream really affects everybody downstream.
An independent report by the National Resources Commission found that right now the break in water flow is the longest since records began. An intense drought, significant upstream water extraction, and climate shift to blame. The report was made following Australia's largest fish kills on record and water shortages in the river system. Mr. Cowie says after the event, no one could drink the local water.
The surface water in the river and the lakes all went sour, and the water authority was having a lot of trouble cleaning it up. Whatever was in the water was reacting to their chemicals, and the water was going black. It was like tea.
The water has since returned to its natural colour, but is now being sourced from Menindee's smallest lake, Copy Hollow. Mr. Cowie says he drinks the water from the taps, but provides bottled water to his guests. He says it's impossible to tell where water will be accessed from month to month.
Now there's nothing coming down the river at all. Where do we go? The bore water, how long is that going to last? We don't know. How long's a piece of string?
Reliable water is hard to come by for people living in outback New South Wales. Many residents in Menindee, for example, get their clean drinking water from donated supplies, while bore and river water is used to wash clothes and water crops.
Meanwhile, further upstream in Wilcannia, the Central Darling Shire Councils say they're on water from the town Weir. But without rain, the town has about 5 months before the source runs out, when they'll turn to treated bore water.
They replenish over a much longer period, and we have to certainly stay within any sustainable limits on that.
Last month, towns in central western New South Wales were forecast to run out of water supplies by mid-November. The first towns to lose water supply will be Dubbo, Cobar, Ningen and Narromine.
We've been very lucky in Menindee. The generosity of the Australian people have collected up water and sent it up in truckloads. It's been absolutely wonderful.
Anita Bolle, SBS World News.